Worship you and we adore you, Lord. This morning we are offering our lives as a living sacrifice to you, Jehovah, surrendering our lives to you, Lord. For there is none that can be compared like to you, Jehovah. We worship you and we honor you. For we pray this, believing and trusting in no other name but the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Jesus.
Amen.
This is the day the Lord has made and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We just want to praise the Lord. We want to tell him all the praise and all the worship belongs to him. Amen.
Amen.
So let's be glad in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Oh.
andiko la watakatifu leo kwa kila kitu tumimbie na malaika kusanyiko la watakatifu leo kwa kila kitu shangilia Yesu milima wanyama mabonde vijana wazee watoto dunia na anga tumimbie pokea sifa
Oh, Nasema ni asante kwa sababu unastahili na hakuna Mungu mwingine kama wewe. Na ni kweli Mungu maisha yetu ni yako Bwana. Na pila wewe Bwana, sisi tumeangamia, sisi tumepotoka mtakatifu. Tunaliinua jina lako tukusema ni asante kwa yale yote ambayo umetutendea Bwana. Wewe ni Mungu uliyekuwa, uliye sasa na utakaye kuwa mtakatifu. Tunaliinua jina lako Bwana tukijua kwamba wewe ni Mungu muweza wa yote Bwana. Wewe ni Mungu ambaye uliumba mbingu na nchi pasipo na nguzo Bwana. Ni nani aweze kusimama juu yako Bwana? Na mtakatifu wewe unastahili Bwana. Maabudu yetu na sifa zote Bwana ni sako Bwana sasa hivi. Ni wewe ndiye tunakushukuru Bwana kwa sababu hakuna Mungu mwingine kama wewe. Mungu wa Israeli, mchana wa leo Bwana, tunaomba Mungu kaweze kuchunguza nafsi zetu kama kuna jambo lolote ambalo tumekukwaza Bwana, ambalo linaweza kuzuia maombi yetu, kaweze kutusamehe na ukaweze kututakaza katika kijito chako Bwana cha utakazo Bwana. Damu ni mwako Bwana kuna nguvu, nguvu ya kuokoa Bwana na nguvu ya kuweza kutuokoa sisi mtakatifu. Asubuhi ya leo Bwana, tunakuja mbele zako tukisema kwamba taifa letu Bwana linapitia mambo mengi ambayo ni wewe tu ndio una suluhisho mtakatifu. Kando na wewe Bwana hakuna Mungu mwingine. Suluhisho la kudumu Bwana linatoka kwako Bwana. Wewe ni Mungu ambaye una suluhisho la kudumu katika magonjwa sugu Bwana ambayo hayana tiba, ambayo sisi wanadamu hatuna suluhisho mtakatifu. Tunakuja mbele zako tukijua kwamba Mungu wewe unatushughulikia Bwana. Na hivi karibuni Bwana utatupa suluhisho ambalo ni la kudumu mtakatifu. Tazama Bwana wakati kama huu kuna wengi ambao wamepoteza kazi. Kuna wengine manyumbani kwao Bwana wanakombana Bwana kuna vita vya nyumbani mtakatifu. Ninaomba Mungu kaweze kuwafikia na ukaweze kuleta amani yako ambayo inayozidi fahamu zetu mtakatifu. Mungu wewe ni Mungu ambaye unatujua na unatutambua Bwana. Na umetuambia kwamba Mungu tupitapo katika kila hali Bwana utakuwa nasi mtakatifu. Hata tupite katika maji mengi hatutazama bali tutainuka kwa sababu tuko na wewe mtakatifu. Hata tupitie miale ya moto hatutachomeka na hatutateketea mtakatifu. Tunajua kwamba Mungu wewe unastahili na hatuwezi kugarikishwa kwa jambo lolote mtakatifu. Tunajua kwamba wewe uko upande wetu na mitego ya mwofu shetani Bwana umeishinda yote mtakatifu. Na umetupatia hakikisho kwamba sisi ni washindi katika jina lako. Mungu kama ungeweza kumtoa mwanao wa pekee Yesu Kristo aje akaweze kutuokoa mtakatifu. Ni jambo lipi ambalo wewe huwezi kututendea Bwana? Tunajua kwamba yote yatawezekana mtakatifu. Na ninajua Mungu wakati kama huu unaweza kuwa mgumu. Lakini naomba Bwana kaweze kutusaidia mioyoni mwetu tukaweze kuwa na uvumilivu Bwana, tukinyenyekea tukisubiri majibu ya kudumu kutoka kwako mtakatifu. Bwana Mungu ninakuja mbele zako nikiomba kwamba kanisa letu Bwana lipo mikononi mwako Bwana. Hata katika mradi ambao Bwana tunaangazia kuweza kuhamia katika shamba ambalo umetupa mtakatifu. Tunaomba Mungu kaweze kufungua milango mtakatifu. Kwa sababu kila kitu kinatoka kwako Bwana na yote yanawezekana mtakatifu. Asante Mungu kwa ajili ya familia mbalimbali katika injini mwetu Bwana. Ninaomba Mungu kaweze kuweza kuwasaidia Bwana ambao wameadhirika na mafuriko Bwana. Wengine hawana mahali pa kulala, wengine Bwana wakati kama huu Bwana hawana vyakula Bwana. Ni wewe Mungu tunakutegemea Bwana ukaweze kuwafikia na ukaweze kuwasaidia katika maisha yao Bwana. Sisi hatuwezi mtakatifu, sisi hatuna uwezo mtakatifu. Unasema kwamba Mungu amebariki wale ambao Bwana wanajua kwamba wanakuhitaji wewe Bwana na ufalme wa mbinguni Bwana ni wale ambao wanajua mioyoni mwao kwamba wana umaskini wa kiroho Bwana. Sisi Bwana tumepungukiwa Bwana, hatuna mwelekeo bila wewe mtakatifu. Tunahitaji wewe ukaweze kutusaidia, ukaweze kutufinyanga Bwana. Tukaweze kukuabudu katika roho na ukweli Bwana na kwa kila hali Bwana. Naomba Mungu ukaweze kutusaidia Bwana, kila kitu ambacho tunakifanya Bwana kiwe kitu ambacho kinakupendeza wewe mtakatifu wakati kama huu Bwana. Wakati kama huu Bwana tunaweza kuhangaika Bwana na tukaweze kusahau mambo yote ambayo mazuri umetutendea maishani mwetu Bwana. Kama wana wa Israeli Bwana waliweza kusahau haraka Bwana, naomba Mungu tusiweze kusahau Bwana, tukaweze kukumbuka na tukaweze kujua kwamba wewe Mungu yupo na wewe ndiye Mungu ambaye uliweza kutenda Bwana na utaweza kutufanyia jinsi Bwana ulivyotutendea hapo nyuma Bwana. Wewe ni Mungu mwaminifu, hudanganyiki Bwana. Wewe ni Mungu ambaye unastahili Bwana. Wewe sio mwanadamu kaweze kudanganya Bwana ama kaweze kubadili nia yako juu ya maisha yetu Bwana. Tunajua kwamba wewe ni Mungu ambaye una mpango mwema maishani mwetu Bwana na utaweza kutimiza Bwana kwa sababu wewe ni Mungu ambaye unatimiza ahadi mtakatifu. Tunakutegemea mtakatifu. Mchana wa leo Bwana tunainua macho yetu Bwana, tunaangazia milima Bwana na msaada wetu Bwana unatoka kwako Bwana. Sio kwa nguvu zetu Bwana na sio kwa viwango vyetu vya elimu Bwana ama vyeo ambavyo tuko navyo kazini ama nyumbani Bwana. Ni wewe Mungu tunakutegemea na tunanyenyekea mbele zako mtakatifu. Hakuna Mungu anaye uwezo kama wako mtakatifu. Bwana Mungu, Elijah alikuwa tu mwanadamu kama sisi Bwana, na wakati aliomba kwamba mvua isiweze kunyesha kwa miaka mitatu na nusu haikunyesha, na vile tena aliomba ikaweza kunyesha Bwana. Asante Bwana kwa mamlaka ambayo umetupatia mtakatifu, kwamba tunaweza kunena chochote kulingana na hali yetu Bwana, na itaweza kupotea. Mungu unayeweza Bwana, tunakuamini mtakatifu, kwa sababu unasema Bwana, tukiweza kuomba lolote Bwana na tuamini mioyoni mwetu Bwana, tutaweza kupata Bwana na litakuwa letu Bwana. Tunakushukuru Bwana, tunakuinua mtakatifu. Uinuliwe milele na hata milele mtakatifu. Asante Bwana kwa kutuokoa Bwana. Asante Bwana kwa ukombozi wako mfalme. Uinuliwe milele Bwana na uhimidiwe mtakatifu. Asante tena na mtakatifu, tunakuinua Bwana. Uinuliwe Bwana. Umetukuka Bwana, umetamba kote kote duniani mtakatifu, na hakuna Mungu aliye kama wewe, na hatuna budi kuweza kulinua jina lako mtakatifu. Tunaomba haya yote tukiamini katika jina la Bwana Yesu Kristo, na kila mtu aseme amina.
My life belongs to Jesus. I don't want to give a big hand to the worship team as we thank God for the opportunity to come and listen to His word. And we are so very grateful that even in this time when we are at home, we can still engage in God's word. What a wonderful opportunity to worship Him. Just to remind us that we can still reach church through the church phone numbers, emails, and contacts, so that we can keep engaged and keep knowing what's happening in our lives, keep connected to the glory of God. As well, to remind you that we continue to give even in our lockdown mode, because giving is a principle and is an order by God that we give. And just to remind you, our pay bill number 837940 for your tithe and offering, or you can pay directly to the bank through bank transfer, and I know that the media team is giving you the information about our Two Rivers NCBA bank account. So we thank God, we really thank God. We want to hear God's word and take a moment of meditation and pray together. And I'm reading from the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 9. I'm reading from verse 24, 1 Corinthians 9 from verse 24. Do you not know that in a race all the runners run, but only one gets the prize? Run in such a way as to get the prize. Everyone who competes in the games goes into strict training. They do it to get a crown that will not last. But we do it to get a crown that will last forever. Therefore, I do not run like someone running aimlessly. I do not fight like a boxer beating the air. No, I strike a blow to my body and I make it my slave, so that after I preach to others, I myself may not be disqualified for the price. Almighty Father, we pray that this your word will speak meaning and relevance into our lives, and that it will bear you much, much fruit to the glory of your name. And we pray this in Jesus' name. The scriptures say that everyone who competes in the games goes into strict training. One thing we know about our God is he is a God who has never lost any battle. He's a God of all seasons, a God of the mountains, a God of the valleys, a God of the night, and a God of the day. He has never lost any battle. Because we are the children of God, he also intends for us never to lose. He has given us principles in Scripture how we can keep winning. And my subject today is how to keep winning. And it's mentioned there in verse 25. What we need to do is be disciplined. He talks about a strict training. And remember, the athletes do it only to win a prize here. But we are doing it for here, and we are doing it for eternity. Therefore, we are even more motivated. In fact, Paul, speaking to us in verse 27, says, no, I discipline my body and permit it and beat it into possession, so that after I have preached to others, I myself may not be disqualified for the price. He's implying that, like what Jesus said, some will come and say, we did miracles in your name, we called on your name, and he'll say, I never knew you. Paul wanted to discipline himself so that he could be able to preach to others, and he himself as well win the prize. There is a prize that we will win. So a few ideas about how to keep winning. Number one, we go into strict training. Everything we do has to have discipline in it. Especially now in the lockdown mode, people are not coming out as they normally did. So they end up having so much time on their hands. And it is required that we discipline ourselves in our eating habits. We discipline ourselves in our time of prayer. We discipline ourselves in our time of reading the word. We discipline ourselves in our time of exercise. And we do everything in moderation. We have to discipline our spiritual lives. Fortunately for the believers, in Isaiah chapter 30 verse 21, the scriptures say that we will hear a voice. So we are not alone. We will hear a voice saying, this is the way, walk ye in it. And so our discipline and our focus and our energy becomes better directed because we have a guide. Jesus said, when I go to heaven, I'll send you Paraclete. I'll send you one alongside you. I'll send you a helper. I'll send you one to give you direction and guidance. And therefore, we have a voice. We don't walk in darkness because you have a voice telling us in which direction to go. Also, we know that our objective is to know the truth. In John chapter 8, verse 31 and 32, Jesus said, you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. So we are seeking this truth. As we walk, as we discipline, we are seeking this truth. He again said in John 8, 36, that when the Son of Man sets you free, you are free indeed, free in every area of your life. And you are free to pursue excellence. You are free to pursue wholeness. You are free to pursue everything you should be, because God wants you to mature and to be full-blown and to give of your very best in every way. Job speaking to us, because we learn a lot from people who walked before us. The scriptures say there is a crowd of witnesses, ones who walked before us. Job speaking to us from Job chapter 23 verse 12, he said that I have considered the word of God my necessary food. I have considered the word of God my necessary food. It means that we need to seek God's word and find nourishment in it, find wholeness in it, because this is what kept Job steady against the storms of life, even as we have storms of life now. So number one, we need discipline. We need the spiritual discipline. We need the physical discipline. And Paul talks about it in the passage of scripture that we read. Unless you practice behind the scenes. You cannot win in front of the cameras. In the recently, we remember Eliud Kipchoge for breaking the record marathon, 42 kilometer, ran under 2 hours. The first time it's been done by a human being under recorded conditions. And we only saw him run for 2 hours, but he'd been practicing for hundreds of hours. In fact, the week he won, he had run already 5 marathons in that week. Every day, he's doing 42 kilometer, behind the scenes in the forest, you don't see him. So the scriptures say as well, for a believer to be able to win, you needed to have the discipline outside the circumstances of your life. You need already to have persuaded your system. Paul is saying that I am fully persuaded. He had convinced himself, he had practiced behind the scenes, he had disciplined himself. And he knew that when the challenge comes, then I can face the challenge. People like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they knew that in the time of challenge, I have already practiced my spiritual muscle enough and I can stand the test. Daniel knew that he could go to the lion's den because he knew in whom he had believed. He had established a discipline. He had established a way. In fact, the Bible says that 2 times a day, Daniel would open the window towards Jerusalem. This is not in a time of crisis. He prayed before, so that when the crisis came, it was easy to continue. But if you wait for the crisis, then you'd be out of form and out of shape. So you have to keep the spiritual discipline. Number two, our focus, among other things we do, our focus has to be on the Word of God and on prayer. In the book of Acts chapter 6 verse 4, there were many things to be done in the church. Even today, there are many things to be done in the church. But the disciples said, let us select men to assist us with the other service so that we can focus on the Word of God and we can focus on prayer. This has not changed even now. The Word of God is the root system of believers. It is where we establish ourselves against the storms of life. Speaking to us from the Beatitudes, the scriptures say, when the storms of life come, not if the storms come, the storms will come. It is when the storms of life come. It is your root system. It is how much you are established on the Word. It is how much faith you have that will help you to stand the challenge of the test. So we have to have Word. And of course, when we hear God's Word, we speak back to Him in prayer. When you read God's Word, there are areas where you take time in meditation and ask God, how does this passage of Scripture apply to my life? Even the passage of Scripture we have read about self-discipline. How does it apply to my life today? And this is the area we call prayer. It's like the branches and the flowers of the trees. That's the prayer segment of a believer. These two have to be firm in your life, Word and prayer. They have to be really your anchor if you are to have a disciplined life that wins all the time. Focus on the Word of God and prayer. In the book of Ephesians chapter 5, around verse 18, the scriptures talk about be full of the Spirit of God. Fullness of the Spirit. In fact, by the time you're reaching Galatians, he is saying that that the fruit of the Spirit is love, peace, joy, kindness, goodness, self-control. You know, he mentions one fruit with 9 aspects of it. And he says this is our objective, the complete maturity of the fruit, the fullness of the Spirit. And in Colossians chapter 3, he puts it even better. He says, let the Word of Christ dwell in you richly. Enrich yourself with the Word of God. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing the Word of Christ. Enrich yourself so that you speak to one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, you know, as you engage with one another because of the fullness of the Word. Remember, we are preparing to win all the times. And remember that what is inside, Jesus said, what is inside is what comes out. We speak out of the conviction of our heart. So our hearts must have received the Word, must have completely digested the Word in meditation, in prayer, in reading, so that that Word now comes out in our speech system. The Bible says the power of life and death is in the tongue. Even in this situation where you know, there has been the COVID pandemic. There are many stories going around. There are much in the news about the danger of COVID, how you can pick it up, how devastating it is. But for the believer, with a mindset to win, the believer talks about the ability of God to overcome COVID. The believer talks prophetically about the season when COVID is not there anymore. Just to inform you, in the past, people died en masse because of malaria, because of flu and such like things that came. But then after a season, they were all gone. The Bible says we have only one, who is Jesus Christ, who is the beginning and the end. Everything else has only one season. And COVID, we want to speak to you and say, you are only here for a short season. And we have seen, by the eyes of faith, we have seen the end of you. So that we go back to our businesses and go back to our normal systems of life and go back to a time of freedom when we can meet together and worship together. So we have to be full of the Spirit of God. We have to enjoy what God has given us as a portion. And the scriptures are available to us, and we can enjoy them to the glory of God. And even as we mature in our faith, what is God looking forward to? God is looking forward to a time when we can bear Him much fruit. God is looking forward to a time when we can magnify Him. John 15, verse 8, the scriptures say, "This is to my Father's glory, that we bear Him much, much fruit." So we are saying that why is God positioning us in this manner? It is because from God's standpoint, He wants us to bear Him much fruit. The scripture speaking to us from John chapter 15, verse 8, He says, "This is to my Father's glory, that you bear Him much, much fruit, and fruit that will last." Especially in this season when we are making disciples, what are those fruits that will last? We need to talk about the goodness of God. We need to encourage people not to fear, but to have faith in God. We need to talk to our neighbors and tell them that God will remain God even after this season. I know especially that people are worried about their jobs. They are worried about their careers. They are worried about the school system. They are worried about the future, you know, ability to pay bills. But we are speaking from the word of God that God hasn't changed. The Bible says that yesterday, today, and forever, He is the same, and so He will continue to be our provider. Philippians 4:19, He says that I will meet you at every point of need according to my riches, not according to our bank accounts or our offices or our jobs or our business. No. According to His riches in glory by Christ. He hasn't changed. Philippians 4:13, He says, "I will still do all things through Christ who gives me strength." So our strength continues to be in God, and we will not change. In fact, in the time of difficulty is when we bear God more fruit. And it's when the fruit is sweeter. Actually, look at the fruits. The fruits from the difficult areas, the semi-arid areas, are normally sweeter than the ones from coming from places where there's plenty of water and rain. It's because why? Because in a difficult situation, the squeeze is in there, and God makes you produce even a higher quality piece of work. It is to our Father's glory that we bear Him much, much fruit. So what we are saying is, our God has never lost a battle. And as believers, we intend not to lose any battles. As PBC Northgate, we intend not to lose any battles. And even you in your family, we intend that you don't lose any battle. You don't lose the battle of maintaining your family. You don't lose the battle of bringing up your children in a godly way. You don't lose the battle of being a positive witness in your community. See, every one of us, we have areas of influence. We have people we go to school with. We have people we work with. We have neighbors. We have security people that we engage with. We have people in the shops where we often go. There are many areas of influence. And we are saying, in those areas, plant a seed, because God wants you eventually to bear Him much, much fruit to the glory and to the honor of His holy name. I'm reminded of one battle The battle of the Amalekites is recorded in Exodus chapter 17. You know, when Moses and Hal and Aaron were up the hill, and Joshua was fighting the Amalekites in the valley of Rephidim. And as he fought the battle, Moses was in prayer supporting Joshua. Very unique. The Bible says that when Moses lifted up his hands, Jehovah Nissi, that's why we get the name of God, Jehovah Nissi, the banner under which we march. When Moses lifted up his hands, Joshua beat up the Amalekites. And when he got tired lifting his hands up and he lowered his hands, the Amalekites would win against Joshua. This is to say, our hope, our trust, our everything has to be on God. If you lower your guard, the enemies will win against you. So what did Moses finally do? They found him a stone and he sat down, and Aaron and Hal both held his hands up so that Joshua was able to continue defeating the Amalekites. And the scriptures say, "Write this down as a remembrance, that I'll blot out the memory of Amalek." God intends to blot out the enemy work in your life. There are things, some things are historical, you know, they come from your grandparents, they drag you back, but God intends to blot out the work of the enemy in your lives. And so we are saying this morning, as we engage God's word, from the example of Job and others, make the word of God your necessary food. As you factor time for breakfast and lunch and dinner, factor time for God. Factor time for the word, factor time for prayer. Go into strict training. Remember Paul, what he said here in the passage we read. He said, everyone who competes and wants to win must go into strict training. And he says how he did it himself in verse 27. I strike my body, I beat it up. I tell my body no to some of the things the body wants to do. Why? Because I want, after I have preached to others, I myself also to win the prize. So four things in summary as we meditate on this passage of scripture. Keep the spiritual discipline. Remember to focus on word and prayer. Remember to be full of the Spirit of God, who is our guide and who is also our counselor and who is able to direct us in the path in which we should go. And remember, along the way, continue to bear God much, much fruit. The scriptures say that God, as we go out to make disciples, to bear him fruit, he says, and I will be with you always, not sometime, I'll be with you always, in the time of plenty, in the time of challenge, I will be with you always. In fact, in Hebrew, he now says that he will never leave you, he will never forsake you. You are not alone. And that's why, because he wins, we also will win, because he is with us always. And he's not afraid of things that frighten the world. He is with us always, to the glory and to the honor of his mighty name. And so, Father, we thank you. We thank you because you are a God who wishes that we prosper. You are a God who wishes that things go well for us. You are a God who is in control of the circumstances of life. You are the one with the keys of the kingdom. From the beginning of time to the ending of time, you are in control. And we are so thankful, especially as we remember that you came down and shed your blood and your life was beaten up so that we could have a relationship with the Holy God. And so we could have a portion of divinity in us, and so that we could become winners, even as you are a winner. And so it is possible also today for us to discipline our lives so that our lives become fruitful in every way. And we pray that you help us. You help us, dear God, so that in everything we do, we will spread out the word of life. We will spread out that word that has power. We will spread out. It's Paul who said that I'm not ashamed of the gospel, because inside the gospel is the power to change lives. First, change my life, Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, to the uttermost, the power to change lives. And our lives are testimonies. There are people who say they don't read the Bible. They read the people who read the Bible. They wash your life. Let your life be an example and bear God much fruit in every way, to the glory and to the honor of his mighty name. We want to speak a blessing on God's people who are watching us online, and we encourage that you invite your friends, you invite your family as well. This is only a 1 hour service. Engage and give God your time so that the Word of God can be part of your life, and so that the Word of God can give you understanding of the things God is doing. God is busy. Bible says that in John chapter 9 as well, that Jesus is saying that my Father is at work. God is at work, even in the COVID time, and he's at work to sustain you. He's at work to make you an instrument for his honor and glory. He's at work to make you a fragrance. Come on, share the word and let people grow in faith. The scripture speaking to us from the book of Thessalonians, he says in verse 23, may God himself, and this is my prayer for you, may God himself, the God of peace, may God himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. May God, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. The scriptures continue to say, and may your whole spirit, soul and body, here we are mindful of your whole self, may your whole spirit, soul and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do it. Let me repeat that blessing again. May God himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. And may your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do it. We speak a blessing on you. Mighty Father, God's people are online. They are tuning in to this message from PBC, from other horizons. And we thank you that they took time out to hear the word of God. Psalms 119, the scripture, the entrance of God's word brings light. May our lives have light. May our lives have hope. And dear Lord, we speak into situations that are difficult and declare that when Jesus shows up, difficult situations become easy. This is the one who turned water into wine at Cana, the wedding in Cana. This is the one who spoke to the storm when the people thought, oh, we are dying in the storm in the sea. He spoke to the storm and said, peace be still. This is the one who spoke to blind Bartimaeus and said, Bartimaeus, start to see. This is the one who spoke to the cripples and said, start to walk. Pick up your bed and walk. This God in him we trust today, and this God we know has never let us down. This God will not let us down. And so we speak life even after COVID days. We speak prosperity in the country of Kenya and in Africa. We speak prosperity in your lives, and we speak a changing of your mind. The Bible says renew your mind, understand the will of the Father so that you can align yourself where the grace of God is flowing, where the goodness of God is there. So that God himself will be able to sustain you through and through. That scripture says from one end to the other end, to the extreme, from the top of your head to the bottom of your feet, the toes, that God may touch you through and through, and that he may lift you up. For you who's going through an extremely difficult time, may you experience underneath are the everlasting arms of our gods. And the scriptures say that as we wait upon him, he renew our strength. Those who wait on the Lord renew their strength. They mount up on wings like eagles. May you look at your circumstances up above like an eagle, because God has lifted you up. He never let you down. Underneath were the everlasting arms, and then he lifted you up. That's why he says he will present you to himself blameless and holy at the day of Christ coming. And he is faithful, and he will do it. And so, Father, we thank you. We pray that none may sleep hungry. We pray that no worried may be broke, that you may come through for your people. And especially for those ones who could be having loved ones who are unwell at such a season, we ask the healing of our God, Jehovah Nissi, that may come your way and that you may live under his banner. We declare that those who walk in the shadow of the Almighty, no harm will come over them. And so we speak a blessing upon you, the blessing of goodness, that as you go and as you come back, that the Lord will protect you. And speaking from Psalms 23, we pray that your cup will overflow to the glory and honor of God's name. And we pray all these things through and through your lives in the name of the Father, the name of the Son, the name of the Holy Spirit. And God's people said, amen. God mightily bless you.